Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Natick in Oak Grove, California, and NatickYarns.com, coming to you live on wonderful Wednesday.
You got it.
Having an extra day off totally, I don't know if this happens to anybody else, but it totally throws off me knowing what day it is, what I'm supposed to be doing, how to do it, etc.
It messes everything up. And then on Sunday, my kid said, "Is it Saturday?" And my husband said, "No, it's Monday." I'm like, "Don't you dare. Don't mess with my weekend."
Right? You're like, don't take away a whole day?
Yeah.
What is wrong with you? You took away a whole day.
Don't do that. I know you're messing with a kid, but now you're messing with me too.
Right? Like, I can't handle you messing with my brain like that. Not when it was 100 degrees out this weekend. I'm just going to say.
It was hot.
It's a little brain damaging if you're out in it. So don't go out in it. That's my recommendation. Was it yesterday? No, I think it was the day before. It was Monday, because I took a friend who doesn't have a car to run errands that require having a car. And on my way to pick her up, there's people jogging. And I'm like, it is hot. Why are you jogging? Jog in place in your house or something. Like, run up and down the hallway. Like, why are you outside? It's hot. That's some dedication to exercise that I do not have. I don't really have a dedication to exercise in general.
90 in Wisconsin? No, thank you.
That seems hot for you guys. I don't actually know, but in my head, really you guys hot. Are always nice and cool.
Yeah, like, our town is right next to the beach in California, right?
Right, exactly. Yeah, it's no. That whole concept. Like, people always think for here that, oh, it must be so scary to live here because of earthquakes. I'm like, yeah, I'm nowhere near a fault line.
Mm-mm.
So, no.
Oh, geez, Nancy, your daughter's going to bike 15 miles. Well, at least you get a self-generated breeze, but wow.
Oh, she's a brave girl. Yeah. We're crazy. We're both.
Yeah.
She's fit, at least.
Yes,
okay.
That's
she's
good.
Got that going for her. Okay, so we are going to wait to announce the grand prize until tomorrow because I don't have all the details. So we'll figure that out probably this afternoon of what we're going to do and announce what the next grand prize will be tomorrow. So today we're just going to show you guys what our daily prize is. Which is one skein of a retired colorway from Alexander the Art of Yarn on a beautiful DK weight base. This just reminds me of, like, sorbet ice cream. Bless you. Earthquake.
Sorry, folks.
Mini earthquake on the phone when we sneeze. We're sorry. So it's got 274 yards on it, and that means it is enough to make the small or medium size of the included pattern. It doesn't want to stay. There we go. This is Solmont, which is a really beautiful knit purl pattern that is just this spiraling design. It's actually a stitch pattern that is best done without a stitch marker for your beginning of round, because then you can just keep doing the sequence over and over and over. Like, we do have it charted and written out for using a marker, but if you can get the rhythm down, it's much easier to do.
Claudia.
Yeah, that was called Earthquake Susan Sneezing.
Yeah, there might be a second one, so watch out.
Yeah, they happen. Unfortunately, the phone does not have that ability to steady.
Yeah, why don't cell phones have a steady cam in them?
Because they want us to buy fancy cameras for that.
Oh, fine.
They want us to spend more money. Are we surprised? Okay, so how you get entered into said daily drawing is by interacting with the video. So today's winner is going to be determined off of Saturday's video interactions. Interacting with us today will get you entries into tomorrow's drawing. So if you react with any of these lovely buttons down here, I'm going to go slow because I don't like getting in trouble. Then you get one entry per reaction. If you comment on the video, then you'll get 5 entries per comment. And then if you share the video is the most entries for not really that much effort, you can click the little button, share to your stories, share to your friends. then you just have to click shared to and where in the comments. And then you get 11 entries per share. Claudia, that only counts as one, by the way. The only keywords we go off of is shared. Everything else is actually physical actions.
Joyce, I saw your suggestion of putting the phone on a tripod, but we move around too much for that.
Yeah, we've tried. I mean, we did do it when the world was shut down and Anna was the only one in the store.
Yeah.
Because that was the only way to do videos. Because can you imagine me trying to, like, selfie mode? Like, here's the yarn.
Yeah, that would be difficult.
It would not have been pretty. It would look about like that, where it looked like I was trying to make shadow animals in the light. Like, okay.
Oh, dear.
Take the spotlight away from me before I get weirder. Okay, so we are going to go over to our handy-dandy comment picker and see who our lucky winner is for today.
Patty Palmer, congratulations. We know you are local, so next time you come to the boutique, let us know you have a prize, and we will get it from the cabinet. Yeah, a tripod on wheels, that's funny. You broke my train of thought, Darla. If you win and you're not local, just let us know the next time you make a purchase. Let us know in the notes that you have a prize, and we will include it in your shipment. Tripod on wheels, that's funny. Picturing myself on wheels holding a tripod, that would be bad.
Heelys.
I know, right? Oh my goodness.
I still want to try those. I'm like, I need to know somebody who has the same size shoe as me has them, just so I can try them.
No.
In a supervised place.
No. Wrap you in bubble wrap first.
And see if I'm talented enough to not fall on my face.
Anybody that has Heelys in a small foot size, please don't tell Anna. Please don't. We're going to transition to some slushies, which you cannot have if you're going to be in Heelys. Oh my gosh, these things are so good.
I don't know why we didn't use those Saturday, because we have some made. Ooh, Karen! Sixes! I wear sixes.
No. No, with a walker,
that's
there
the
you
wrong
go.
Link. Oopsie.
Oh, Kathy, you have no idea. No.
I think I can do it.
Once.
I like Claudia's
until you fall
with a walker. We'll
yeah,
try
that
it
one's
with
good.
A, like, training wheels first.
Oh my goodness.
Please let's do this. This will be fun. Karen said bummer too small. We'll just shove socks in the end.
No. Let's talk about yarn. That's safer.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm
okay.
Actually excited for today's combination.
Right? Like,
I still want to do that project.
Which one?
The one I told you to.
The magazine one.
Yeah.
Should I start with showing them the magazine one, or start with showing them and telling them about the yarn?
I say the magazine, but we're going to let people decide.
So, pattern first, or yarn first? I mean, there will be lots more patterns, of course, after the fact, but...
Oh, Jackie, can we see a recording of that? That would be hilarious.
Speaking of which, I'm going to get a link for the magazine.
Oh, good, Claudia. We're going to need that walker for the test and afterwards.
You know, I tried a skateboard once and didn't die. I'm just
I fell on my behind so bad. Because I was slick and I was wearing actual real Vans. Those suckers stick to skateboards.
Oh. I used to have Vans, but not anymore.
I think we're getting a tie there on...
yarn, pattern, yarn, pattern, yarn. Oh, I see one more yarn than pattern, so we're going with that.
Do it at the same time.
Yarn, pattern?
Yeah. You put the pattern down, then the yarn, and then...
Okay, let's try that.
Okay.
This seems like a good combination to start with, then.
Okay, are we ready?
Yes.
All right.
Hopefully there's not too much glare.
No, it's, it depends where I stand. That's pretty good.
Okay, so, unbeknownst to me that Susan has an obsession with this pattern and wants to make it, I decided it's hot, we need summer projects, so we need to do something with the new Sonata and Sonata Shima and original Sonata together. So then she was like, well, what about the pattern in the magazine? That's awesome. I'm like, oh, okay, well, we'll talk about that too then. So in Noro Magazine 22 is this beautiful wrap called Currents, which is short rows in garter stitch. Like, here's a really good close-up of the short row section. These little waves, like right here, are your little short row sections. And this one basically has four skeins of the more solid color, and then one skein of one of the Sanada Shima, which are the self-striping colors, and that's those little two-row ridges in between each section.
I am so in love with this pattern. Let's show the close-up here of this one.
I think you need to figure out, because I know Lisa wants to do it, you need to figure out how to do it as a
the other
convertible
way.
Wrap size and the other direction.
Yeah, so this one is knit this long way. Ways. I want to do one that goes this way.
So figure out how to turn it sideways and turn it into one of our convertible wraps. And I did not just tell you to write a new pattern.
I'm on it.
Because that adds to my to-do list when I tell them to do things like this.
I am so in love with this pattern.
Right?
Yeah.
So that's kind of your little hint to the video today, which is lots of combinations of these two yarns together. They are both the same yarn, but the color techniques are different. So Sanada is the kind of more tonal, very subtle self-stripings, and Sanada Shima is the more colorful self-striping. It is sport weight, 393 yards per skein, 35% cotton, 25 viscose, 20 silk, and 20 polyamide, which is essentially nylon, which gives it some nice strength and durability so that you can even make garments out of it. I have in Sanada color 40, this beautiful like turquoise light blue. And then we have Sanada Shima in color number 1007, which is indigo and a bright turquoise, a cerulean blue, a rust, a lemon, an olive. There's a little bit of like a lilac gray. So you've got all these pretty oceany shades. And some of the patterns that I'm featuring this morning would only take like one in one. Some take two in one. I just went for things that made me happy for combining the two colors together.
Before anybody falls in love with the color in the magazine, that color is sold out at the vendor. So
do not
don't fall in love with that gorgeous blue that I've already fallen in love with, but it's out of stock. So we got lots of good choices for you here because I'm all over this one.
Yeah. Well, and what's funny is kind of more of a surprise is that this one also pairs perfectly with 40 in Sanada. This is 1004 in the Sanada Shima. But look, it's got that little pop of a turquoise. You've got blush pink, rose pink, cranberry red, lemon yellow, a little kind of citrusy orange, some orchid, purple pink. But it's that turquoise that really makes this combination pop and tie together beautifully.
When we're done with the video, I'll put some color combination numbers in the collective when I do all of the linking there.
And I will, like, as I set them places, I will make sure that I keep, you know,
thank you,
colors grouped together so we remember what we did 5 minutes from now.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? They still have that cup.
I know.
Apparently it's not very popular because normally they sell out of them like a minute later.
Oh my gosh, if you guys like Starbucks, they have this almost see-through neon green.
Oh, with the pink
cup.
Lid? If
yes.
That was more green and less yellow, it'd have been a Boss Lady must, but it's a little too yellow.
This is my cup we're talking about right now. They still have that one at Starbucks.
Yeah, they had one of the neon one when I was there.
Yeah, that's what they had in Fresno when Meg sent me the picture.
And if it's not stainless steel, I'm not buying it because the plastic ones don't keep anything cold. All right, so a couple fun projects. This is Spark of Gray by Melanie Berg. I'm going to click on the gray one for better like stitch definition.
Oh, that one, yeah.
It's like that two-color starburst. But look how pretty it is when you do it with a self-striping and a solid. Like, totally different look to that star stitch pattern.
I want to see the whole thing without shadow.
Let me see.
Click on it and you should be able to get to... Yeah, right there.
Oh, this one might be better. Yeah.
Oh, that's so pretty.
Kind of reminds me of how, like, on Sail Away, how depending on which color is more dominant. Sail Away
Okay. There's a lot
of sailaways. Depending on which color is dominant, like, because the blue is so dark on this one, it kind of obscures the starburst pattern. Because it's not super high contrast like the original silver and charcoal, but it's really pretty.
That would be so fun.
And that one's going to basically take, go back, like one of each.
Because
you could, you know, if you have to end a repeat early anywhere, no one's going to know. The ribbing's plenty wide, so if it has to be shorter, no big deal. Because it's like just 50 yards over what two skeins would equal. So go with close enough.
Yeah, it's a shawl. Nobody's going to know.
Exactly. So that's Spark of Gray by Melanie Berg. And then one more before we go back to colors. This is a great summer top, this Comfort Zone Tank. It's the self-striping paired with the solid in the body and then just the solid at the top and at the hem. So you get this beautiful transitional section. I want one that zooms more than this one. Well, that's not any better. But it's stockinette up here. Then it's got like a textural stitch pattern down here. And then I believe they did stockinette again at the bottom because it's curling a little bit right here. But I would do, this is one of the times I would actually do garter at the bottom because it would look like you transitioned from smooth to texture to the most texture with the garter. So it would look on purpose. But just a really cute summer top that in cotton yarn is going to be amazing. And they have from a 32 to a 58 3/4. And it's going to take 2 to 4 skeins. Approximately total. It may take, you know, one more of one of them, depending on where the yardage ratio breaks down. But very easy. This one's bottom up, so the whole beginning of the top is like knitting a cowl.
Nice.
We're just going to favorite this one so we don't forget it later, because it's really cute and might need to go on my needles. All right. There are more colors. I have lots more patterns, of course, because you know the Ravelry rabbit hole happened. Ooh, we got all grainy and weird. Hopefully that's just our internet. All right, I have another one that I couldn't decide which color to pair with it. So it has two friends. This is Sonata Shima color 1008 with the beautiful spring lime green, lemon yellow, persimmon orange, chocolate, turquoise, a little sand. There's some denim in there. It's funny, the longer you look at these, the more colors you end up seeing.
Mm-hmm.
Claudia, you couldn't do that sweater on the machine because it has a textured pattern. You'd have to modify it to be all stockinette instead. So it would, you could do a version of it, but slightly different look. Okay, so if you want to keep your color combo more subtle, color 26 in the regular Sonata is this gorgeous springy mint green.
I was going to say, Darla, this one's for you.
Right? It's Darla colored.
Yeah.
And then if you want more of a bold contrast, this color just came back in. We haven't seen this color in a while. This is color 41, this gorgeous deep emerald jade. It has a slight blue leaning that makes it a little more jade. But you can see it's got highlights of like a lime and then shadows of more teal.
Where is it more true on the screen? Right there?
That's probably the closest. Oh, she wants the green a bit darker. Well, here you go. Darker green. There's not an in-between, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, she said the second combo is mine. So okay, she likes the darker green.
There's a... over there. Did you put that one?
No, because it would be... I tried that one. It was...
Okay. Such pretty combinations. I'm going to scoot things over a little bit here.
This is one of the ones where...
Ooh, look at these two.
Right? Like, I mean, that's it. You start going, okay, these all go together. So I had to stop at one point or another.
Sometimes we have to.
Go insane. Since I could easily go insane and have fun with that. But then the video would be 3 hours long. Look at this. Look at this. Okay, more projects. This is Destination Unknown. This was, you can tell, designed with, like, a slow color-changing yarn, because you can see, like, blue-brown.
Oh, sure enough.
Blue-brown.
Thought that was shadow.
You can really see it in this picture, yeah. But that picture's a little bit blurry, so it doesn't show the texture
as well.
But this beautiful, like, mosaic tile kind of stitch pattern. I love the detail where they have that line.
Right, it looks like a zipper.
Right? And then you've got, like, the little polka dot mosaic lines. Here's a more colorful one.
Wow.
But this one would also easily be one that you could do one in one, because again, if you need to stop a little bit early, it's not going to hurt anything, because it's just a very, very short repeating pattern to create the sequence.
Volume has gone low.
On them?
Yeah.
I wonder if
there's two lights. I don't know what it's supposed to look like when it's working properly. Okay, we're gonna try it with the microphone again.
Just gonna turn it off and back on again.
Yeah. We're waiting for it to restart itself.
Okay, well, the blue light's coming on, so I'm gonna assume that means that fixed the sound for you guys, because technology is exhausting. I don't know, I guess it's so hot out there, stuff's not working right or something. It's not even hot yet today. It's only 69 degrees. We have the doors open to let the fabulous cool air in. All right. Then this one, I had to show you guys the project first because you're not going to believe this is the same pattern, because they did a solid color for the background and then the self-striping for the mosaic stitch. And they made it longer, and they made it short-sleeved, but it's this.
Whoa.
So they made it not cropped and short-sleeved instead of long-sleeved. And I love her patterns because she has a size range of just shy of 31 to 63.
Nice.
And that's still only the equivalent of 3 to 7 skeins. Obviously, because of needing equal colors, you might need like 4 to 8, but still, that's not that much for a sweater. And this yarn is very budget-friendly, and it's nice and cool for the summer, which is what we all need, because apparently y'all are hot out there, too.
Yeah, there was a world record heat day on the 3rd.
For who, here?
The entire world. It was. I'm not sure where it was, and it was an average, but it was like, oh my goodness.
Okay.
It wasn't that bad.
Claudia, not hard at all. Both of those patterns I just featured are just mosaic knitting, which is knits, purls, and slip stitches. Nothing actually hard about it. All right. I'm going to slide these two bundles behind me to make room for more. This one's for the Lisas of the world.
Mm-hmm.
We have the gorgeous Sunset Orange, color 27, which is this really rich, deep fall orange, paired with color 1005, which is, it's like summer in a skein. You've got crimson, red, vermilion, persimmon, olive, a little sand, some taupe. There's kind of a sage green in there.
Then you have a strange definition of cool. 92 where she is.
Okay.
That might be cool for there. I don't know which part of that state you're in, but...
It's not a small state either, so it's anybody's guess.
Darla, these are so pretty. These are my sister's colors, too. I better watch out. I'll be knitting an orange one before I know it.
All right, here's another one that I have to show you guys the project first, because look how beautiful this is. They just use, it's just two colors. It's your self-striping and your solid.
Is that double knitting?
I think it's knitting around.
Oh, yeah.
But it's the same thing as this. And it's like, this does not pull me in like that other one does. Because, you know, I'm a colorful person. But, so this is the same pattern. It's a free pattern, which gives you more money for yarn. And you're just repeating this sequence of changing the directions. And then I love that sometimes there's like multiple stripes, and sometimes there's just this one little thin stripe that creates like little triangles. This one could easily be done any length. You could stop at any section because they did it 74 inches long. I'd probably half that just because, one, I want to knit lots of things, so I'm going to need to finish that one so I can do more things. Okay, then this one, Wind, is a really cute summer top. I love that it's V-neck, and then they did this stripe sequence where it's this solid color for, like, your big stripes, and then your self-striping color for your two-row stripes. And they did, I believe this is actually a seam, but they did it with the seam on the outside to give you that, like, ridge look down the middle. And this one is the equivalent of 2 to 4 skeins for sizes 33.5 to 59.5.
That's very cute.
I really like this one. You can kind of see she made it a little more like tunic-y length, but if that's not your jam, just stop knitting. That's an easy adjustment. Once you know what length you like from your armpit to your hem, ignore whatever length the pattern says. Do what you like, because you're the one that has to wear it, not the designer. And I guess you don't have to wear it, but you should wear your knits.
Hopefully somebody wears it.
Yeah, I'm with you, Darla. I'm still trying to figure out where to find an extra day of the week. Y'all thought you were funny saying that, you know, yesterday was my extra day of the week.
It was.
And I'm like, that doesn't count because there are still only 7 days in the week. We need the week to be 8 days, but that 8th day be a secret that nobody knows about.
Joyce, I think that would be an easy pattern.
Which that top would be very easy. It's mostly knit a row, purl a row with a little shaping around the neckline and the armholes, and that's it. All right, this combination, we have a beautiful navy blue, color 34, paired with Sonata Shima in 1002, which is beautiful lavender and blush pink and cornflower and lime and this kind of brass tone, some white. This one's very spring, like whereas this was very summer, this is very spring. Yeah, exactly. A day between Saturday and Sunday.
I like it. That's all I did Sunday was knit.
I unfortunately managed to still not be able to just knit any day of the weekend.
Do you, Anna, knit 15 inches and then ribbing, or does your 15 include ribbing on the bottom?
So I include the ribbing in my total length. So if I measure from here to here and I like 15 inches and I want 2 inches of ribbing, then that's 13 inches of whatever else is in between there, whether it's stockinette or stitch pattern. Like even on Lemon Spritz, it was 2 inches of ribbing and 13 inches of everything else. 13 inches of the lace. Because, yeah, that's your total length, so then you have to divide it up based on what is going into that section of your sweater. I have so many good patterns this morning. Like, I need to go knit now.
It's not the day between Saturday and Sunday. Like,
I know.
We can't knit right now.
I know.
We need a name for that.
I have to sell you guys yarn instead, because share the love. Right?
Yeah, I'm trying to come up with a name. Sadunday?
Oh, stop. Oh, stop. Okay.
Ooh, that's pretty.
Slippy V triangle is perfect for a combination of a solid and a self-striping. It's got this beautiful, like, textured rib top edge, the colorwork textured rib bottom edge, and then at the end, this one will have it, you have that textured rib as a border with this beautiful V-stitch pattern in between. This is the Slippy V Triangle by Stephen West. You could definitely get it out of two skeins because, again, their yardage is about 50 yards over, but stop the body part, a repeat early, and then do the border till it runs out.
I wonder if the body is treated as a knitted on edging.
I don't think so.
I don't know the construction because it's knit.
Yeah, I think it might be.
Knit this way.
No, it's knit this way. Because see the stripe? Follows across this way.
Well,
so like this would be a row. So right, I think it's like intarsia, and there's probably an increase or something right here, and then finish out the row. Because this all look, like at the edge looks continuous. So I don't think
somebody start that so we can find out.
It could be. No, it might be because of this little line right here, but that might be increases also. So
yeah.
Yeah, somebody.
That one's been on my maybe
somebody
list.
Somebody knit this one and let us know.
Yeah.
Susan.
It's on the maybe list, not the must knit list.
Okay, and then another cute summer top. This is another Andrea Mowry. This is Metamorphic that I had to show you the project.
That's cute.
Look how cute it is as a T. It's just garter stitch, two row stripes. You've got a slip stitch down the middle. Slip stitch on the side seams and then down the shoulders, which I really like that little extra detail down the shoulders.
I think this is cute. I'd leave it out of the front. Just me.
Oh, see, I like it. Because it gives you that vertical line, the contrast.
Oh my gosh.
But that's this one.
That's so different.
So short sleeved, brighter color combo. She made it longer. Like this, it's a perfect example of make the sweater for you, not for the designer. Like make the changes you want. And this one has 9 sizes. It takes from 4 to 2200 yards for a 33 to a 65. Like voila, beautifulness everywhere.
Very gorgeous. Yeah, Claudia.
Oh, Saturday and 3/4.
Oh, I like it.
Pam said that's if you're a Harry Potter fan. I'm like, I'm not really a Harry Potter fan. I know of it.
Yeah, I'm not a fan, but I get the
I could go with that. I could go with that term. That makes sense to me. This one, the number is cut off, but I think that's color 17 in this beautiful shades of violet colorway. Look, it's got little pops of, like, pink or pinkle.
Gosh, no, I might do that color. I can't decide. You have too many good ones here.
We'll just put sticky notes in a bag and draw for you.
Well, scary.
I thought about that combo, but that was very subtle. So I decided to put the purple with this one, 1003, which is the pretty rose pinks and olives, lemon, lavender, blush. Like, this is another very happy spring palette. It's the more pink spring versus the more purple spring. Let's just go 4 colors. There you go.
There you go.
Like this, just go nuts.
Yeah, better keep those 4 together for me.
Okay.
Because it's so pretty.
Don't worry, I have more projects.
Okay, what about, I have to, what about those two?
The purple and the orange?
Yeah.
It's a little, high contrast. I'm not in love with it, but I don't have to be in love with it. This is your project.
Yeah, I might have broke Anna.
It's not hard to do.
Just a tiny little stripe of orange. It'd be really pretty.
Okay.
In the magazine shawl, Currents. Who's on my side? Come on.
Who likes purple and orange? Help me out here. Oh, Kathy said pretty combo. There you go.
Slide that purple next to the purple variegated. Well, yeah, these two.
All right, this is another I have to show you guys the finished project before I show you the pattern, because look at the contrast of doing a solid and a self-striping.
You sure that's not two self-stripings?
That's, you know, now I'm thinking it might be.
Oh, yeah, for what they used, it is, yeah.
Well, okay, there you could use your pink and your purple together.
Yeah.
But so much more bold than this.
Oh, my God.
Right? Same pattern. Just the yarn choice makes such a difference, because her stripes are very subtle. She has like a gray and a spring green with speckles. But it's just that kind of, I call it the leaf shape, where it's got that decrease down the middle, and you like increase out so far and then start decreasing back down the other way. Cass Pinka called it a kite shape.
She did a whole, this one did a whole series of that.
Yeah, of the shape. Of shaping. And two skeins.
Nice.
All right, one more project. This cowl verso is really pretty. You've got stripes. You've got this beautiful, like, diamond detail right here. Really simple lace pattern, just with you've got stockinette here and reverse stockinette here, so it gives it a really high texture contrast and makes it look more elaborate than it is. Some slip stitches, some modified feather and fan, some more stripes. And this one is easily, like, two skeins. I mean, you could get two cowls out of your two skeins.
Yeah. So pretty.
I have one more color combination for you guys. Right, that's why I was like, I have to show you guys the projects on some of these, because I'm like,
so different.
Such a different pattern. Like, I like Kalara, but Kalara in self-striping is even more amazing. All right, we have Sonata Shima in color 1001, which is the neutrals, the pewter, the chocolate, the cream, the coffee.
Yeah.
I had to go there. And then pair that with, here's your espresso right here, 42, this beautiful, rich, dark, dark brown. Right? Like, this is the best neutral out there. And I really love this brown. Like, this is, like, a surprising color for me, that it's really rich and bold. You could, if you wanted a more rich palette, 1005 would look amazing with this one for a good contrast. Like, so many good combinations this morning, and while I could keep going, that would not get the boutique open or shipping done or any of that fun stuff. So we're going to pop over and talk about classes right quick before we run out of time. Ooh, that's a fun combo.
Too many choices.
So I'm going to link the calendar for you guys, because I cannot stand over there and talk about classes and link patterns over here. There's just not two of me. That would solve the knitting problem, too. Just figure out how to have two of me. Okay, hopefully I set that down and didn't, like, just give you guys all an earthquake sound. Okay, so coming up, starting,
like, where are we?
I'm like, where is, oh, she rearranged. I'm like, she sends to the bag.
She did.
Like, oopsie. Okay, so starting on Saturday, July 8th for the in-person, and on Zoom, July 11th. Is the coloring box cowl. This one uses one of the Jade Sapphire coloring box kits that has 10 mini skeins of luscious cashmere amazingness yarn. I did finish my cowl out of it, but you knew it was going to be warm in here today, so I chose not to wear cashmere. Chose to wear linen. But this one, really fun for those who want to learn to do Fair Isle. You have knit, 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 Fair Isle for two rows. Knit, 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 Fair Isle for two rows. So you get like little breaks of don't do anything but knit. So it's great for like, okay, I need a minute. Okay, now I can work on it again. And it comes in, I think, six. One, two, three, four.
I think so.
Six. Yeah, six different color combinations in the kit, so there's sure to be a color for everyone. Then on Friday, July 14th, we'll have our Casting on Three Ways class. That one is, we're going to teach you three different cast-on techniques because while we love the long-tail cast-on, and that's our default for most things, sometimes you need something different. Like we'll teach you the cable cast-on, which is good for the underarm. We're going to teach you a ridiculously stretchy cast-on because sometimes you need stretchy. Like, there's lots of options in cast-on, so we're going to teach you three more that are nice and useful. Then Knitmas number three is going to be on Saturday, July 15th in the boutique from 3 to 4 p.m. and online on Zoom on Tuesday, July 18th from 11 to noon. In this one, we actually are going to teach you right from the beginning of the project. There's not even a garter tab cast on, and we're going to teach you how to do this simple feather and fan pattern on this super cute cowboy cowl. And it only takes one skein of most worsted weight yarns. Ours is out of the Silky Twist Inspirations Club contrast color, coordinating color. It's color 763. It's blue and purple and amazingness.
Even though there's no garter tab to learn, there is homework, so you have to do all of these rows right here.
It's like 22 rows and not that many stitches by the end of those rows, so it will go very fast. Then on Friday, July 21st, we have the It's All in the Lace cowl. This one has a simple garter stitch section first that's your pre-work so that then in class we can teach you this beautiful lace. We actually have two versions here. This one's out of soft lino, so if you want to do a lightweight version for summer, actually our new linen whisper would be amazing for this project. And you only need either the two colors or you can do it all in one color if you're not a, you know, pop of color person.
I had to knit those two together.
Right, there, it's too fun.
Yeah.
And then for our crocheters, on Friday, July 29th, we have the Stop Short Crochet Cowl, which is a little play on words because we're going to teach you a technique on not having to do short rows, but getting the look of short rows, because you'll see we have tall sections and skinny sections, and it's got all these ripples that look like short rows, but none of those are short rows. It's all in varying the height of your stitches. So, and that one is three colors of worsted weight yarn.
That's our look. I need to buy more yarn. I signed up for Knitmas 3.
You're welcome.
We'll take a quick look at our cashmere coloring box color choices. That's the purple that our sample is in. Rainbow and one more down here.
Okay. So then we'll move on to what are we wearing, which I am wearing a lightweight linen scarf because it's summer and linen is great for summer. It is a fairly quick knit. It does have a little bit of short rows in it, but this is one of those projects that's kind of perfect for learning short rows because there's not that much. And it's all in the, like, garter stitch sections in between the lace. So you can see, like, skinnier up here, wider down here. So there's never short rows and something else going on. It's very easy peasy. This one, I think, is about 300 yards. Yeah, so three skeins of the new linen would do it.
One skein of Sonata?
One skein of Sonata would easily do it.
Nice.
But yeah, I just wanted something that was nice and cool for the weather. They, on the pattern, they show it wrapped around like a shawl, but I like to do it as a little scarf. We just wrap it around, and I tie these little under and tuck them underneath. And normally I put a scarf cuff on right here, but I forgot this morning. So sometimes we forget to wear our pretty things. All right, and then let me, I think I linked yours already. Yep.
This one is Rainbow Road out of Worsted Weight, and suddenly I want to see it in this.
Ooh.
We did do a sport weight modification, didn't we?
Somewhere. Yeah, because isn't that the sport weight one?
Maybe, yeah. Oh, okay, yeah, it is.
That looks, I'm like, that looks like the sport weight mod.
You're right. It's written for worsted, but we did sport weight on some of them. Just lots of different texture. Plain stockinette section that you could add decorative buttons. Mine are still sitting on the shelf because I never sewed them on.
And it, all these textures are just knits and purls, so nothing is hard. Except counting.
And it's only, you have to count to 10, so I only struggled a little bit.
And you can place markers, which makes it
save your
much
life.
Easier for counting.
Ooh, just remembered where I was when I knit that at a comedy show I was working on.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
Was the delayed reaction on Susan's part?
Took me a minute.
Okay.
Oh my goodness.
All right, you guys, that's going to be it because we have about 10 minutes until we open, which means I can get a few more of your orders packed up and on their way out the door. So thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Have an amazing day.